Well, hello, and thank you for clicking in. Today, we are looking at the most famous pieces of jewelry from classic movies. And it fits really well with the topic of vintage jewelry and vintage style and how to collect and wear vintage, because movies have always influenced fashion. The jewelry that is the most famous in movies is highly collectible, and the style that created during that time period is also collectible. So today, it's a fun one filled with eye candy, vintage jewelry from classic movies. And these are my favorites. I can't say they're the most famous, but they are definitely my favorites. And if you have other suggestions or things you think I missed, or things that you think are more famous or are your favorites, please let me know in the comments below. So in today's video, I am showing you the movies, and I also have a couple pieces from my collection that actually are influenced by or in the movies themselves. So it's going to be really fun. And the first one we're covering today is the tin cup necklace.
Oh. He's crazy. Oh, God, he's right. You're right, Roy. Just knock it on. Let her rip.
Oh, my. You're losing it.
Oh, I have lost it.
So is he. He's crazy.
Honey, so are you.
Rene Russo wore what became known as the Tin Cup Necklace in the 1996 movie Tin Cup. And that tin cup necklace influenced women for the rest of the 90s and became a classic and is still worn today. It has a lot of different iterations. In the movie, it was pearls strung far apart, almost as stations, with chain in between. And then it became an invisible necklace. It became something with cable in between. Different gemstones were eventually used, or crystals. And I have an example here that I inherited from my mother. And this is pearl. This is a later one, but it's still indicative of the influence and the style that this necklace created, because it has the far apart pearls. And then I hung a beautiful antique carved coral from it. I believe this is angel skin. I also inherited this from my mother, and this is quite beautiful. Next up, we have the Titanic heart, the famous blue heart of the ocean necklace that was made famous in the Titanic movie. This necklace did so much for vintage jewelry in general, and it became such a trend that they even sold replicas, I believe, through the mail at the time. Okay, so my very favorite jewelry in any movie, I feel it was practically a character in the movie, but to me, this was a character, even though it wasn't really mentioned. It just became so iconic, and I have a replica of it. And of course, I'm talking about Audrey Hepburn, Breakfast at Tiffany's, the famous scene, the opening scene, where she's holding that cup of coffee and the pearls are draping down her neck. Thank you. And I bought some replicas, some very good replicas that were made from the originals. And they're in this great pink box. And this is the brooch. And that's what it looks like in the back. The construction is really wonderful. Very well done piece. And then it's made so that it can be incorporated into this necklace. The box for the necklace, and it has instructions that come with it because it's several pieces. There's this extra pin so you can take, because the necklace is long and heavy and has different layers, graduated layers of pearls that are meant to also be worn down the back, because it was influenced by the movie. So there's this piece, and then there's the necklace itself. And this has the hole in it, in the clasp, so that, see the hole? So that this, so that the pin can be worn attached to it, and then you can wear it in the front with the pearls draping down the back. This is what the necklace looks like by itself. And here's what it looks like with the pin attached. And I wore this last Halloween. I went as Holly Golightly, and it is definitely better than Halloween costume jewelry. It's fine, fine costume jewelry and really collectible and really special. But I wore it last Halloween as part of my costume as Holly Golightly, and it was so much fun. And another personal favorite is the incomparable engagement ring given to Grace Kelly by the Prince of Monaco. It is a Cartier diamond, and it is 10.47 carats, and it was so famous, and it was such a compelling story of the time that they let her use it in her last movie before she became Princess Grace of Monaco and retired from Hollywood. The movie was high society. It was hysterical, and you can catch glimpses of the ring all through the movie. And here's my favorite scene from the movie. It's totally camp, and you can really see just how elegant the future princess was, and there are glimpses of the ring in this clip.
How do you do? I'm Tracy Lord. You must be... Oh, of course you are. I adore strangers. Oh, do sit down, please.
That sister of yours.
Isn't she a dear? And so talented. Oh, but we're afraid she has a homicidal streak. Did you get lost finding her?
No, not at all. We had good direction.
Good.
I do hope you don't mind our being here for your wedding.
Oh, but I'm delighted. We have so much cake. What is your name, dear?
No, thank you.
I'm so sensitive to names.
Oh, my name is Elizabeth Imbrie.
Elizabeth Imbrie. Oh, it sounds like a medieval saint who was burned to death. And you?
I'm Mike Connor.
Oh, Michael, what a lovely musical name. Now, you mustn't be ashamed of it.
Oh, but I'm not. Mike is for Macaulay.
And what's the Macaulay for?
My father taught English history in high school. My friends call me Mike.
Oh, of whom you have many, I'm sure. Oh, English history has always fascinated me. Cromwell and Robin Hood and Jack the Ripper. Where did he teach? Your father, I mean.
South Bend, Indiana.
Oh, South Bend. It sounds like dancing, doesn't it? Oh, you must have had a most happy childhood there.
Oh, it was screams.
Oh, I'm so glad.
I didn't mean it that way.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
It's all right. It's a natural mistake.
Are you the photographer or the,
I take pictures.
Oh, it's a great art. Did you bring your brownie? Oh, then you must be the one who's sort of a writer, Mr. Connor.
Sort of, yeah.
Have I read any of your novels?
I doubt it.
Oh.
I haven't written any.
Oh, but you must. Why, Mozart composed at 13. You must be at least 30. Time is flying. Where were you born, Miss Embry?
Duluth.
Ah, Duluth. That's west of here, isn't it?
Sort of, but we occasionally get the eastern breezes.
Are you two, going together?
I love Miss Lord.
It's an odd question, I must say.
Oh, I don't see why. I think it's fascinating. Why, birds and spring, it's sort of the intimate little detail that you like to write about, isn't it, Mr. Connor? Oh, but if you'd rather not have your privacy invaded, I will certainly respect your wishes. Oh, please. If you'll excuse me, I'll see what's keeping Mama. Mama is so eager to see you. Mama!
Another very, very famous ring from a classic movie is, of course, the One Ring from The Lord of the Rings. I actually have a vintage version. I've had this in my collection probably for about 15 years, maybe even 20.
Hold out your hand, Frodo. It's quite cool. What can you see? Can you see anything?
Nothing. There's nothing. Wait. There are markings. It's some form of elvish. I can't read it.
There are few who can. The language is that of Mordor, which I will not utter here.
So this is called the One Ring. It was also called the Ruling Ring. And this was out of The Lord of the Rings by Tolkien and also The Hobbit. In 1937, it was the magic ring that granted the wearer invisibility. This, my friends, is an exquisite carved cameo. This depicts a woman walking with her dog and an angel. Look at the carving of the trees. This is an oversized cameo. This is large. And the reason I'm showing this to you today is because this is going to be in a fundraising auction it's a fundraiser with prizes that I am doing for to benefit the people affected by the war in Ukraine. So this will be offered and you have a chance to win it on May 20th. So it's coming up very soon. And this is oversized, and there is a very famous oversized cameo from the movie Gone with the Wind. And it was worn by Vivien Leigh. And that cameo is so famous because it absolutely stole the scene. It was even bigger than this. It was borrowed from the costume designer's mother. It was a genuine antique cameo that came from her family. And it was shown on Vivien Leigh, and women just went crazy for it. And it started a cameo craze, an oversized cameo craze, and a very Victorian revival movement that lasted well into the mid 40s. And the movie came out, it was Gone with the Wind, and it was in 1939. This is the very famous Corocraft bangle bracelet. It's the Camellia bracelet. It's also known as the Carmen Miranda. It was worn by Carmen Miranda, two stacked on one side. The movie that made this so famous and influenced so many women and the fashion of the time was called Weekend in Havana, starring Carmen Miranda in 1937.
We gotta get going, where do we go and what are we gonna do? We're on our way to somewhere, but only me and you. All we see there, who will sit there, what'll be the big surprise? There may be caballeros with dark and flashing eyes. We're on our way.
We're on our way.
Pick up your pack.
And if we stay,
we won't come back.
We won't come back.
How can we go? We haven't got a dime, but we're going, and we're gonna have a happy time.
It's extremely rare and valuable, and if you'd like to find out more about rare, valuable costume jewelry, I have an entire video on that. I'll put the card to it up here and a link to it down below so you can watch. This is also in that video. Another great movie where the jewelry practically became a character is, of course, Gentlemen Prefer Blondes with Marilyn Monroe and that very famous Diamonds Are a Girl's Best Friend scene. Here's another scene That isn't shown quite so often, and just as fun.
I don't listen, but whether you listen or not, I'm going to tell
Come
you...
Come on in, honey. You can hear better in here. Oh, am I intruding, or is he leaving, one hopes?
I'm leaving. But, Miss Lee, before I go, I'm going to tell you this. Because once in a while, even a mercenary nitwit like you has a decent impulse. Don't let your friend here get mixed up in any of your schemes, because I'm going to rub your nose in them. And I don't want this character to get hurt on the way.
If you've nothing more to say, pray, scat.
That's about all. Honey, except for telling you I had money, which I haven't, everything else I said to you, I meant. And it wasn't part of my job either. Think about it.
Why did you just stand there and let him kiss you?
You want to hear something crazy? I think I'm falling in love with that slob.
Oh, you just feel that way because he's poor.
I hope so. Come on, let's change. We dock in an hour.
Also, what might be my very, very favorite is, of course, the snake belt worn by Elizabeth Taylor in Cleopatra. Eugene Joseph's wife, Joan, who later ran the company after his death, she was actually measuring Elizabeth Taylor for that belt. And after she measured her, Elizabeth Taylor corrected her about the measurement. And it was known at the time that everyone noted or wrote down measurements for Elizabeth Taylor and then essentially made what they needed to make with the correct measurements. Joan knew that she would not argue with Elizabeth Taylor, but just simply added the length of the belt so that it would be the right measurement.
Elizabeth Taylor as Cleopatra, siren of the Nile. Her stunning beauty and notorious intrigue turned the tide of civilization.
You will kneel.
I will what?
On your knees.
You dare ask the proconsul of Rome?
I asked it of Julius Caesar. I demand it of you.
And then finally, again, probably my most favorite. Everything is my favorite when I'm talking about it, but this truly is special. The jewelry worn by Carrie Fisher in the Star Wars movie, the original Star Wars movie, as the character Princess Leia. Her necklace and bangle bracelet were designed by Bjorn Wexstrom. I had pieces with the correct hallmarks that I auctioned off recently. And if you're interested in watching that, it was a very fun, exciting auction. And I'll put the card to that up here. And I also got myself one after that. I just fell so deeply in love with the bangle that I found one online. And it doesn't have the same hallmarks and it was made much later, but I truly love it. And here's a scene from the movie. May the force be with you. Thank you for watching and see you again next time. I believe they're, oh man. I believe they're still making these, I believe they're still making these today. Auction earlier, and I will. November and November, and don't make it till December in the springtime, in the summer, or when autumn leaves are falling. She will love her here. Come on, shake up, shake up, shake up, la la.